Hello everyone, Professor Franz here, and today we're going to talk about monopolistic competition. Here are some characteristics of monopolistic competition. The first thing I want you to remember will be product differentiation. So think about apparel, restaurants, and soaps. Restaurants, we just perceive restaurants as different. So for example, fast food is different from Japanese food, which is different from French food. So restaurants are differentiated. Same as soaps and apparel. And there is low entry barrier. So think about restaurants. As long as you know how to cook and you have a kitchen, then you can enter the restaurant business. You do not need cutting-edge technology or a large financial capital to enter the industry. So there's low entry barrier. And as a result, there are many firms in the market because it's easy to enter, it's easy to exit. And the market demand curve is always downward sloping. However, each firm will be facing a downward sloping and yet a lot flatter demand curve. So each firm is facing a much flatter demand curve than the market demand curve. And because a firm is facing a downward sloping demand curve, even though it's very flat, it's still downward sloping. And therefore, the firm has a little bit control over the price. Let's compare the difference between the market demand curve and the demand curve that each firm faces in monopolistic competition. So the market demand curve is very steep. The purple demand curve on the left-hand side, that's a market demand curve. But each firm in a monopolistic competitive market will be facing a downward sloping, but a lot flatter demand curve. So you can see on the right-hand side, the navy blue demand curve is a demand curve that each firm faces in monopolistic competition. Now, the reason why a firm in monopolistic competition faces a downward sloping demand curve and not a horizontal demand curve is because of product differentiation. Say you are operating a Japanese restaurant. Some people just really love your Japanese food. So even though you increase the price a little bit, then this consumer is not going to go away. Contrast to perfect competition, because perfect competition, you're selling homogeneous product. So you don't have any say about the price. If you raise the price a little bit, all your buyers will switch to a different seller because you're selling exactly the same product. But here, in monopolistic competition, due to product differentiation, even if you raise the price a little bit, there will be some consumers that will stick around. But notice that the demand for your restaurant food is very elastic because consumers can easily find a substitute. Let's say your restaurant raised the price too much. Your ramen, instead of $10, it's $20. Now your consumers will say, no, ramen is too expensive. Forget about that. Today I'm going to eat hamburgers. So you can see that if you increase the price too much, the quantity demand is going to shrink a lot. And therefore, the demand curve that your restaurant faces is a very elastic, although downward sloping demand curve.